Life just sucks, man. You eat, you shit, you die. Maybe just plus a couple other pleasurable activities, such as fapping, sleeping, sometimes having a cheerful and engaging conversation with some people with whom you happen to share a common ground or two, and then you just die. You know, but not knowing when exactly, where exactly such death would occur. But hell, what's the point of knowing anything for sure anyway? Because we are going to go back to that non-existent state, that void, state of void. Devoid anything. And I couldn't help but start thinking that God can be a real asshole sometimes, since, you know, he doesn't heal your illness, but instead he tells you to endure. He tells you that my grace is sufficient, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. So such verse should already suffice to make you realize that you can't just pray away your illnesses, your infirmities, you know, just like that. No, it doesn't happen that way. You know. It's just a wishful thinking. So as a result, sometimes I begin to have some thoughts about converting to Islam, you know, since Christianity is so far such a piece of shit, you know. Well, I don't have to follow Christianity so that I can receive Jesus' blood atonement, so that I believe in Jesus' blood atonement. Yes, because I'm currently not part of any church, and I resent, you know, attending any events at any church, since all of them, with no exception, are just a bunch of self-righteous, narcissistic hypocrites that they, you know, who just tell you, do this, do that, go south, go north, east and west, home is best, that sort of crap. But what else can you do? What else can we do? What else can I do? Well, the good thing, the pros about the Bible is that you can choose to read your Bible in any language. While the Quran, according to my knowledge, the vast majority of Muslims believe that a Quran written in Arabic has the final authority in terms of accuracy and correctness, blah blah blah, you know. but I don't want to learn Arabic anytime soon. It's just freaking hard. I already have French to learn, and it's taking me like a million years to just get myself familiarized with the conjugations and the verb tenses of French verbs. It's freaking driving me nuts, man. But I have to learn French since I currently have no other choice of making myself remain productive other than my work, other than content creation on YouTube. And I can't go outside, due to the lockdown. But I heard from my aunt saying that the current residential sub district isn't imposing stringent restrictions as you imagine, since you don't have to present your QR code or the so-called health code to the guard, to the gatekeepers sitting at the gate of this residential sub district. Excuse me, I beg your pardon if my voice sounds a bit strange. Because I just attempted to reset my messed up circadian rhythm over again, and I had myself drowned in another sorry state of my mind. It's just I would have chosen euthanasia if I could head to Belgium, but currently the current Chinese regime isn't issuing any new passports unless you have very good reasons to convince them that you do have such urgent need to depart from China to another state. So it's just bullshit, man. You eat, you shit, you die. It's freaking shit, man. Life is just shit, and I didn't choose to be born. But even if I am chosen by God, God predestined me to speak in His defense, to preach. to preach the gospel and whatnot, to spend eternity with him in his kingdom. Well, I didn't choose that, man. I didn't choose. I didn't choose to be born. I didn't choose to dwell in this sorry state. I didn't choose to have severe depression. I didn't choose to make a YouTube video, actually, but since I have no other choice to express my grievances, obviously I can't just roam on the streets and handle a pad. Handling and say to hell with the party, to hell with the president of XXX state, XX country. Freaking nasty, man. Shit. And my grandma called me a loser for not having a girlfriend, for remaining a celibate. Well, I didn't spend much time rebuking her. I just pretty much remained silent, you know. But I just don't have the strength to rebuke anyone but myself and God. Well, so the point is, just don't expect God would treat your ailments. You don't expect to pray away your illnesses, your infirmities, since it's part of life on planet Earth. We live in a corrupt, in a highly corrupted world, surrounded by highly corrupted people, supported by a highly corrupted system, and advocated by a highly skillful, highly advanced, highly sophisticated, highly organized groups of darkness, groups of spiritual wickedness. Yes, that much I do believe. But currently, I just don't believe in any church anymore. Why should I believe in any church? Since they don't give a shit about me. They just do their own thing to try to earn as much bucks as they can. You know, to draw in order to draw as many supporters and advocates as they can manage. So that's the whole purpose of a church, you know. Of course, according to the Bible, a church out to support their her members in case of need. What do you expect from humans? What can you expect from humans? We constantly rebel against God. We constantly even rebel against ourselves, our own free will. It's just shit, man. Everything is just freaking shit, fucking shit. So get your fag ass out of my face.